time is it? You know what time it is. It's time to hit that subscribe button. Where is it at? And hit that little notification bell while you're at it. And it's time to follow my Instagram, Geekly Amanda, GeekyAmanda, Amanda. Same on Twitter. And it's time to get this movie review started. Well, a little over a week ago, you might have been following me. I went to the red carpet premiere of Maleficent, Mistress of Evil, and I have a review for you. Angelina Jolie is back along with Elle Fanning, and they are reprising their roles as Maleficent and Aurora. First of all, their chemistry on screen is something else. With playing the mother-daughter roles in this, even from the first movie, you've seen that chemistry. Maleficent and Aurora have this mother-daughter connection, and it's even stronger in this movie as it was the first. Newcomer, not to the movies, but to this film series, is Michelle Pfeiffer. No other than my girl, Michelle Pfeiffer. And let me tell y'all, she brings it. She brings it in this movie. You see her acting chops like you've seen nothing else. I don't wanna give anything away. This is gonna be a spoiler-free review, but let me just say, we saw in the trailers that her and Maleficent do not get along. She knows what buttons to push a Maleficent, and she does it just right. Plays the queen, the mother of the prince who is betrothed to Elle, Aurora. They're going to get married, and she's trying to come in. We saw this in the trailer. She is trying to come in and take on that mother role and play some Maleficent. And Maleficent ain't having it. She is not having it. And you see her evil side come out in this, which is the first movie. That's what I said. Maleficent is a villain. She's a villain in the series. So we see her evil side come out of this. And I'm loving it because I'm like, this is the Maleficent that should have happened. It totally is darker. You will see some deaths and violence and Maleficent's evilness, like I said, come out. So I'm loving that factor about it. Cinematography is beautiful. Oh, at the beginning too, when you see, what is that? The moors and all the trees and the flowers and all of that. It looks gorgeous. And then they showed the new kingdom where Aurora's fiance, Michelle Pfeiffer, the mother of the fiance, live. And that is done beautifully. Oh, it's so gorgeous. I wanted to jump right in the screen and just live there. Now, one thing I gotta warn y'all about. This version, like I said, is much darker. You're gonna see deaths. You're gonna see deaths and people that you love dying and blood and things shot up and all that stuff. It is darker. This is the Maleficent that should have happened in the first one. How does Disney do it away with? You're gonna have deaths. You're gonna have deaths that you mourn. You're gonna see violence and all, but it still gives you that like Disney feel. How did they do that? When someone dies on the screen, but then you're still like, oh, this is still like a good Disney movie. How do they do that? I don't know. But I'm gonna tell you, they are pushing that PG line. If you have younger ones that, you know, have a little problem with a little violence and get scared in the darker side, I'ma heed you some warning right now. You might not want to bring. A friend of mine made a good comparison on the violence in this. I guess in Maleficent 2, the first one, when they had that end scene and what, you know, the real, when the wings, and it was kind of that more violent, darker scene. If your kids were all right with that, then I think they're going to be all right with this movie. If not, look, you spinning the roulette wheel with that one, because you will get some violence, you will get some deaths, and you will get some darker scenes. One reason I appreciated the second movie is it's so much different than the first. With Disney having all these remakes, I mean, we're getting a remake here, live action here, reboot of this, a reboot of that. This story veers so off of the original story. You're getting a whole new story, all these new plots, all these new characters. It's like a new world that's opening up, and I love it. I'm here for it. Like I said, I love this one more than the first movie. I thought the characters came back. We got the ones we know and love. Angelina, seeing her on screen. Aurora, and of course my girl, Michelle Pfeiffer, who I can't get enough of. I give this one an 8 out of 10. I enjoyed it. I think you will too. If you're a fan of the Disney movies, I think you'll enjoy it too. And if you like the first one, I think you'll like this one even better. So if you've seen it already, let me know what you think. Comments, thumbs, and all that. Questions, if you have any questions. I know I'm not giving spoilers, but I'm here to answer them. And until next time, y'all, mwah!